Welcome back to my AI Handbook channel. In this video, we're covering 5 of the most important and fun updates in AI right now. First, Qwen3 just released wild new features that push open weight models even further. Then, we'll look at how Manus is now free for everyone, no waitlist. After that, we'll dive into HunyuanCustom, an open-source video generation tool that's seriously impressive. I think you like this part the most. Next, we'll break down how Gemini 2.5 Pro is redefining video understanding, and finally, we've got 2 last-minute updates from OpenAI that you don't want to miss. Just a heads up, at the end of the video I'll share exciting news about Gemini that I found for you. You won't believe what is coming. Let's get started. Qwen just dropped the quantized models. You can now deploy Qwen3 using Olama, LM Studio, SGLang, and VLLM, and they come in multiple formats along with the technical report. You might remember that the key innovation in Qwen3 is the integration of thinking mode for complex, multi-step reasoning and non-thinking mode for rapid, context-driven responses into a unified framework. This eliminates the need to switch between different models and enables dynamic mode switching based on user queries or chat templates. This really makes using Qwen a breeze and super effective. I want to show you a few key points make Qwen3 stands out as well. In this graph, Qwen3's top model in reasoning mode is now the leading open weights model in Artificial Analysis Intelligence Index, right behind Google, OpenAI and Grok models. They have also emphasized the importance of cost-efficient open-source models by saying, "We've always been open with our AL approach and will continue to support developers in building cost-efficient AL solutions." Besides, here, we see a clear distinction between the Qwen3 models in reasoning and non-reasoning modes. For example, across all of the evals in Artificial Analysis Intelligence Index, Qwen3's top model used 74M total output tokens, 71M reasoning, 3M output, in its default reasoning mode with cost of $45, and 7M total output tokens in non-reasoning mode with cost of $5. This is crucial for developers, businesses, and policymakers to optimize AI deployment, balance performance with cost. Speaking of accessibility and scaling, here's some good news: there is no more waiting lists. Yes, I am saying this for Manus AI. Finally, Manus AI is now open for everyone to use, no waitlist needed. You'll get a free task every day that you can complete for 300 credits. Plus, all users will receive a one-time bonus of 1,000 credits just for joining in. Now everyone can start using Manus right away and earn credits as they go. You just need to go and log in. I usually rate how excited I am about each event, just like I do in my videos. So, in my recent post on X, I talked about subscription prices. I said that having access without a waitlist is wonderful for first-hand exploration, but I am 4/5 excited because I know that long-term use of Manus will still be expensive. I was just checking out the pricing on the Manus website. They're offering 1,900 credits a month for $19. That basically means 100 credits cost about $1. Honestly, that feels a bit on the pricey side compared to what we usually see. Even if you upgrade to a bigger plan, the credit-to-dollar ratio stays the same. I feel like they might want to revisit their pricing if they really want more people to use it regularly. What do you think, guys? Drop your thoughts in the comments. Let's chat and share ideas. Would love to build a helpful and friendly community. Next up, let's move into something a little more visual, literally. Hunyuan introduced HunyuanCustom, which is an open-source, multimodal-driven architecture for customized video generation, powered by Hunyuan Video 13B. You know what is the most exciting part? It outperforms existing open-source models. It even rivals top closed-source solutions. Let me show you the key features. Here is the single subject video customization. Basically, you just upload an image of your character with a prompt text, like he's walking a dog, then it just creates coherent videos with new actions, outfits, and scenes. Check how consistent it is with whole AI scenes. You can also compare the model with other top models for each prompt on the website. Another key feature is multi-subject video, which generates videos with multiple subjects. For instance, you provide 2 different image inputs with prompt like, "A woman rides a tiger wandering through the fields," to generate a video for you. And the last one is audio and video driven feature. This feature helps you to sync audio with visuals for talking or singing in any scene. It is perfect for digital avatars, virtual customer service, and more. And the last example is changing reference image in a video. Check this out, how easily it changes the bag in the source video. It is just amazing. Now, let's talk about a name you've definitely heard before, Google. Because they've just raised the bar. As you guys remember, we analyzed the Gemini 2.5 Pro in our previous videos on our channel. Now, Google has achieved an amazing advancement in video understanding. They say in their blog post, these models mark a major leap in video understanding by achieving state-of-the-art performance on key video understanding benchmarks, surpassing recent models like GPT 4.1 under comparable testing conditions, same prompt and video frames. Check out the comparison table of Gemini 2.5 Flash and Pro. The Pro model has made huge strides in video understanding for each benchmark. In some cases, it even outperformed human understanding, which is incredible progress for Google. Let me illustrate the power of Gemini 2.5 Pro with a few examples for better understanding. Gemini 2.5 Pro unlocks new possibilities for transforming videos into interactive applications. This is Google AI Studio Starter app. I will leave the link below. It uses Gemini 2.5 to make learning from video content more effective and engaging. For instance, you drop the video URL here. I did it for you since it took a bit time to load. And it creates an interactive application to help you to learn topic better. It is just one click. Other than that, Gemini 2.5 Pro unlocks exciting creative possibilities, such as the ability to generate dynamic animations from videos with a single prompt. For example, when you give in video on Project Astra along with the prompt, create an animation in P5.js covering the different landmarks seen in this video. Gemini 2.5 Pro analyzes the footage and produces a corresponding P5.js animation. And lastly, Gemini 2.5 Pro can identify specific moments within videos using audio-visual cues with significantly higher accuracy than previous video processing systems. For instance here, it accurately identifies 16 distinct segments related to product presentations in 10 minutes video, by using both audio and visual cues from the video to do so. Very impressive, to be honest. But AI's potential isn't just about creative tools, it's also about impact. And OpenAI's latest release proves that. OpenAI published a blog post about new evaluation called HealthBench. They announced it in their post by saying, "Evaluations are essential to understanding how models perform in health settings. HealthBench is a new evaluation benchmark, developed with input from 250-plus physicians from around the world. To be more precise, a team of 262 doctors from 60 countries spent the past year creating HealthBench examples. Firstly, in this blog, I want you to pay more attention to the first sentence, improving human health will be one of the defining impacts of AGI. They are emphasizing that AGI won't be just about automation or intelligence, it will be about elevating human life. They position AGI in a way that inspires hope, not fear. Check out the HealthBench scores by theme graph. O3 is the top model, beating out other models like Claude 3.7 Sonnet and Gemini 2.5 Pro. In recent months, OpenAI's frontier models have made a whopping 28% improvement on HealthBench. This growth is a huge step forward in improving healthcare and finding cures for more diseases in the future. Lastly, this graph shows the model physician and physician-physician agreement for HealthBench consensus, which is very important data for trustworthiness of HealthBench. You see that model is overlapping with individual physicians in most of the case. Based on this, we can conclude that HealthBench grading closely aligns with physician grading, suggesting that HealthBench reflects expert judgment. As a result, here is why OpenAI conducted and shared such a report with us. They say, one of our goals with this work is to support researchers across the model development ecosystem in using evaluations that directly measure how AI systems can benefit humanity. We hope this supports shared progress toward using AI systems to improve human health. While I was making this video, OpenAI announced two more exciting updates to ChatGPT. I didn't want you to miss them, so I've included this update in the video too. Firstly, you can import your deep research, included past and new ones, as PDFs with various features like images, links, sources. I found this very helpful and lifesaver since you keep it wherever you want and organize accordingly. And lastly, they have added GitHub integration into ChatGPT so that Deep Research Agent can read and search the repo's source code. Now, it is time for bonus content. While Google I/O event is approaching, there is a rumor about new Gemini model called Ultra. Gemini 2.5 Pro is one of my favorite already, and I look forward to Gemini Ultra model. I have a feeling that it might be the first AGI, any thoughts? Let me know in comment below. So there you have it. Major updates from Qwen, Manus, Hunyuan, Google, and OpenAI, all in one video. Each of these launches opens new doors for creators, developers, and everyday users. Just quick question, how did you find this video style? If you let me know your opinion, you help me a lot to improve myself, thanks in advance. And if you found this breakdown helpful, consider subscribing and hitting that like button, it really helps more folks discover these insights. Let's help each other. Until next time, stay curious and keep building. I'll catch you in the next video.